Hi, I'm Josh Ellsworth, General Manager of Stahl's CAD-CUT Direct. When working with vinyl cutters, there's three big settings on any style of cutter that you need to remember. Those settings are speed, downforce, and offset. When I survey decorators that use vinyl cutters, 9 out of 10 of them have no idea what offset means or how to adjust it on their cutter. They just don't use that setting. And that's a problem. That's just as important as speed and downforce. That's why they're the big three settings. So I'm going to explain to you offset today, and we'll show you by example. So first, take your blade holder, load it into your cutter, and let me walk you through the offset setting on the Roland GX24. We're looking at the control panel up close on the Roland GX24. You'll see the three settings are right up front. I have my speed set at 50 centimeters per second, my downforce for this particular material at 110 grams, and my offset is that other number that you probably never look at or never know what it means. And for this particular material, I have 0.25 set as my offset. Now, offset is the way the machine compensates for the degree angle of the blade. So the 45 degree blade comes standard with this particular cutter, and Roland recommends that you use a 0.25 offset for this blade for your standard thickness vinyls. So that's going to give me accurate cuts on this particular job that I'm going to send. So I'm already set up that way. I'm just going to send a job, we'll let that cut, and then we'll come back and adjust the offset and show you the difference. That's a name cut with the accurate offset. Now I'll adjust the offset. Consult with your cutter manual for exactly how to adjust the offset on your machine. It should be pretty easy to access. But when I go into the setting on the Roland GX24, offset is always going to be a number between 0 and 1. So it's going to be a decimal. Right now it's 0.25. That's what Roland recommends for this 45 degree blade. For standard thicknesses, I'm going to adjust that to an inaccurate setting to show you the difference. So I'll just do a small adjustment up to 0.4. The issue that I'll show you later would really be magnified if you're higher. The further you get away from the accurate offset number, the more complicated it gets to weed your design and the more inaccurate your cuts get. So we'll program 0.4 and let me run a job at that setting. Let's take a look at how these two different cuts compare with just a small change in the offset. First, the accurate cut. Looks really good. And now the inaccurate one with just a slight change in the offset. The further you get away from the recommended offset, the more difficult it will become to weed your design because of inaccurate corners with the way the machine's compensating for the angle of the blade. And also you'll see some actual inaccuracy in the quality of the work. Look at this indent on this R. That's because of inaccurate offset. Look at the way this corner bows out. Look at the tick marks in the O. So if you've seen these types of things before with your cut, and it will be magnified as you get finer detail and sharper points on fonts and designs, you probably need to adjust the offset. It may not always be an inaccurate blade or cutting strip or something wrong with your machine. It could just be your setting. Let's look at the good design in these same areas. Much better. Now I went ahead and cut one with an offset of 1 to show an extreme example. Almost changes the whole characteristic of the font. I doubt your customer or you would accept this. It's not tough to see that there's some major problems here. And one last example, let's show you when the offset isn't high enough. This is an offset of 0. It's actually lifting up my design at all the corners here. The corners are starting to round and it's not really wanting to complete the cuts. So let's compare the good, the 0.25 offset, and the rounded one. material actually started to tick out there. So I smudged the marker, but you can see where it didn't cut completely on the rounded edge of the O, and all of your corners are rounded. It almost doesn't even look like the same font. So hopefully that gives you a little insight about that mystery setting on your machine called offset. Now you might be saying, wouldn't it be great if the machine just came in the box with the right offset for the blade that it comes with? And the fact of the matter is that most machines do. So you'll be all set up for the factory blade that comes with the machine. But the problem arises when you start to need to accommodate thicker materials or want to cut different types of materials, whether it's sandblast material, flock, thicker vinyls, reflective, high detailed work, things like that, where it's recommended that you switch to a higher degree angle blade. If you just switch to that blade and you don't switch your offset, odds are you're going to say, this stuff's too tough to cut, my machine doesn't cut it, and you're never going to try it again. You need more sales opportunities with your cutter. So it's important to understand how offset needs to be changed in accordance with the blade that you're using. And you don't have to waste a ton of material to accomplish this. You can simply conduct the test cut function on your machine to see the difference, as I've done here. And that's it, a quick lesson on offset. I'm Josh Ellsworth with Stahl's CAD-CUT Direct. Thanks for watching.